Here we go again, looking at the Arizona real estate numbers, and we're going to find out who the top four cities are. Of course, you can always read below. I put the numbers in there. But it's supposed to get down to 37 degrees Saturday night. So it always does this the second week of December. I remember this one brokerage I was with always had an outdoor Christmas party, and we were all standing underneath these heaters like penguins on the roof because it was, I don't know, 29 degrees or something. So, and we all freeze when it gets that cold. So if you're watching from Michigan, I know you have no sympathy whatsoever. Today we have 6,864 homes on the market. That's about 300 lower than last week. And it looks like this. The blue line is the number of listings that come on the market over the past 7 days, and the yellow line is, you know, the number of contracts. So it matches last Thanksgiving. Listings are going up higher this year than last year. Last year was pretty bleak, but the bleakness continues. So this will turn. This will start coming back down as we get into Christmas. And then we, as we've been lamenting, going to hold our breath and see what January brings us. I got a message from a real estate agent in Boston. He said, yeah, he goes, it's 2021 was pretty tough for me too. He said, I hope 2022 doesn't bring the same. And Judy says, good morning. Market is slowing a bit, probably because of the holiday. Give it a week or so. It's typical. The holiday, we just go down. And the interesting thing I noticed is we had 950 homes come back on the market. This means people took them off the market for Thanksgiving. If your home is listed, don't take it off the market for Christmas. Don't remove it and then put it back on, because it doesn't show up as a new listing. It just shows up as back on market. And the reason I say leave it on is that, you know, after Christmas, people have opened the presents, they've had a dinner, they're kind of sitting on the couch, and some of them just start looking for homes, and then you're not there. You can ask your agent to restrict showings. Don't show it on Christmas Eve or Christmas Day. And you know what? They're not going to show it anyway on Christmas Day. Nobody's going out. If I have a buyer say, hey, I want to see a house Christmas Day, I go, well, drive by it because I won't be with you. So that's what's happening. I said, don't take your house off the market for Christmas. That's my advice. So who are the top four cities? Let's quickly take a look here. Number one, this surprised me, Santan, up 40%. Rounding out at number 8, 9, and 10, we have Gilbert, Surprise, and Glendale. Glendale is number 10 at 30.1%. So those are the cities that were really knocking it out of the park. So I wanted to go over and take a look at their inventory situation. And this is Glendale, I believe. Yeah. So Glendale has 242 homes on the market this year, and last year they have 191. But see how they dipped way down here? I got to pull that back up again. It always does this to me when I try to show something, it refreshes. So we're going to go back to Glendale here for just a moment, because I want to illustrate where the pricing growth came from. It was right here, because the inventory was so low. We were down to 160 homes, then we were down to 114. So they're up 30% for the year. Well, most of that occurred down here. Let's see. Oh, thanks, Judy. And Dabmar Romy, do you have any idea what the next number of people, families are moving to Arizona? I don't have that. I got a couple articles here that show you some job growth that might point that out. If I look here and I go to the city of Surprise, I'm going to pull off Glendale here. And it, unfortunately, this chart does not break out Santan Valley. So I wish it did. It just includes it with Queen Creek. But it's the same situation. See, that bright price growth occurred when we were way down here in the basement with only 133 homes for sale. Today, 266. 2019, you were over 500. So whenever you get this big dip like this, prices will start screaming up, and they have. So, and what's going on? Global home goods company signs major industrial lease in Glendale and could hire 3,000 workers. That explains Glendale's growth a little bit, doesn't it? Look at the size of this thing. And it's an artist rendering. So it says that the Williams Sonoma, a global retail company known for its kitchenware and home furnishings, recently leased about 1.2 million square feet of industrial space in the Cubes in Glendale. And if you've been buzzing around out there, you know, you can see all this construction that's going on with these industrial parks. And the average wage out there for this place is, they say, going to be about $45,000 to work out there in that warehouse. Let's see. I do nationwide recruiting. I'm seeing increases in candidates looking for jobs here in Phoenix metro area that are from California. Yeah, Jody, my brother, they just sold one of their Airbnbs up in Port Angeles, Washington, and that buyer came from Lake Tahoe. Another offer came in from Bellevue. So we are seeing a lot of people coming here from California, but every state's seeing an influx from somewhere. That's just a common problem with lack of available home. And you can live anywhere you want now in most jobs, so people are doing that. So here's another thing here. This is a new mall that Scottsdale developer unveils plans for a 700,000 square foot outdoor mall in Surprise. So you don't have a lot of these in Detroit, do you? So this is the artist rendering outdoor mall, and they've got one in off of the 202 south in South Gilbert. And they're really cool. The outdoor malls are nice. You can stroll around, especially this time of year. You don't find me out there in August. But it says they've unveiled plans for one of the first major outdoor shopping malls to be developed on the West Coast in a decade. They haven't been building malls lately. They're not building the indoor ones. They're just doing the outdoor ones now. It's going to be 700,000 square feet. It's going to be off the Loop 303 in Wattle Road. And it's going to feature TJ Maxx, Home Goods. That's a warehouse I just showed you. Marshall's, Five Below, PetSmart, Ultra, feature a restaurant row and entertainment options next to planned multifamily project with more than 500 units. So you can live out there. And, you know, I was up in Sun City yesterday, and just before I got Sun City, I ran into two developments that are build to rent. And, I mean, and they're just packed tighter than sardines. And there's a lot of that going on. So there's a lot of rentals being built. Mortgage rates, 3.22. Yesterday they were 3.20. They have been trading in a narrow range since October, going up an eighth of a point, down an eighth of a point. They're just kind of hanging in there. With this new virus coming along, markets reacted and went down an eighth of a point because they thought, oh no, here we go again. Now they're seeing that the news perhaps is not that grim, so went back up an eighth of a point, and it's just going to bounce around for a while. One of the things that I ran into too in this next article is these projections. This is the month where everybody says warehouses, house prices are going to go, and Zillow came out with their projection. Now, it's interesting. People said Zillow got out of the market because they saw bad news coming. Well, they're projecting 13.2% increase for next year. So that kind of washes that argument out of the way, doesn't it? They didn't get out of the market because they saw house prices falling. Let that sink in for a minute. They're projecting 13.1% increase next year. Their iBuyer model just failed them. But for this year, 2022, they're saying, and this is off of Phoenix Business Journal, the role of institutional iBuyers and other non-owner occupiers, with billions in capital raised this year, investors are expected to play a key role in the housing market in 2022. In the third quarter, investors had a record three-month period buying nearly $64 billion of the homes and increasing their market share in several U.S. metros, with us being the most active for iBuyers. Prolifically in the Sun Belt, it says, the growing prevalence of the cash-heavy investor has frequently been cited as a headache for buyers already in fierce competitive bidding situations. Absolutely. An open door and offer pad, I don't think they're coming in and squeezing out the regular buyer because those people weren't listing their homes anyway, so there never was this competition. Is it keeping some homes from being listed? Yeah, but those people were listing out of convenience because they just wanted a cash offer. They're having a new build. I notice there's a large majority of people going with these iBuyers when they have a new build because they like the flexibility of selling the home and then being able to sit there for a while. I don't know for the life of me how 72 Sold says you can stay in your home for up to 6 months. I have to talk to an agent, find out how they do that, because there must be some kind of different financing that's being offered there, because when you get a loan, you can only lease it back for 60 days. You can't lease it back for 90. You have to move in there in 60 days. So I don't know how they get away with that. So Navmar says, so is the water the main limiting factor to expansion in Arizona, and given the expanding water filtration technology, has that has made water a factor. A lot of conversations about water, but I don't see any builders holding back. I don't see any cities having restrictions. I know a few years ago, Prescott clamped down because they were having a water shortage. It's about 2 hours north of here, and they restricted building because of water. Not reading a lot about that right now, and I think we should. So water can be an issue. Filtration, you know, are we converting salt water? Not yet. So it's, you know, time will tell, but sooner or later, we're going to run out of water. I'm contributing to the inventory issue here in Arizona by listing this wonderful place in Sun City. And here's the remodel kitchen. It's $289,000. It's in over 55 development, and it's just a cool little place. And you know me, how much I like these 360 tours. You can walk around and take a look at it. They got an enclosed patio out here up to a green belt. It's two bedroom, two bath. It's pretty slick. What's really neat was I used Red Hog Media, and when they did the 360 tour, she was able to take it and turn it into a floor plan. So I've got this on the listing. So it actually shows you the floor plan of the house and all the measurements, and the camera does that for you. So it's pretty cool. I love this company. She does an excellent job, shows up on time, and she cooks the pictures pretty good. I know how to do those 360 photos, but I'm not good at post-processing. So I have the camera. I use it occasionally, but I hire the pros. So I don't want to go out there and pretend I know. I know enough about photography to know I shouldn't do it myself. I get back here and I try to cook and make them look better, and they look just awful. So, and measurements. Yeah, Jorge, the measurements. That I think these floor plans, I'm going to do this with every listing from now on. I think it's a great deal. So that's what's going on in the Arizona market right now. Things are changing ever so slowly. Let's watch the inventory number as we get closer to Christmas. I'll bet you we end up below 6,000 units, down like 5,800. At that point, people are just going to stay home. So remember, if your home is on the market, don't take it off for Christmas. Leave it on there. Let people look at it. Have a great day.